I'm sorry, can you repeat that? You're providing for?
Free.
Free.
Not free for a week, not free for a month, free forever.
We've had a lot of discussions in the context of larger groups about where our field is right now, where we need to be going. And a lot of these conversations have centered around the registered behavior technician, behavior tech, whatever verbiage you want to use, but the direct service providers that are working with children with autism. And I know that you guys have some really strong feelings in terms of how we should be training these people and how we can elevate the work that we're doing. And so I'm hoping that you will share what you've been working on as a way that for you to address this.
Yeah, so what we see today are companies creating online training, 40-hour online training, and charging $99 or $150. I was talking to a student in Saudi Arabia where they're charging like $500 for an online training, and I've had it with it. And so what we've decided to do is create an online training, 40 hours. We don't think it's enough, but it meets the requirements. We've created
it meets the requirements of what?
The BACB to earn your RBT. And so we created a 40-hour online training that we're providing for free.
Sorry, can you repeat that? You're providing for?
Free.
Free.
Not free for a week, not free for a month, free forever. It will be going up very soon online. Anyone can go to our website, autismpartnershipfoundation.org, click on it, get free RBT training forever. We will never charge a single dollar for RBTs to be trained, because I'm sick and tired of watching people make money off this kind of training.
Joe, why was this important for you to participate in and to make sure that you guys got done?
Well, I think the nice part about this, other than that it's free, is that we wanted to really step up the training just a little bit too. So yeah, it's the 40 hours and it meets all of the requirements of the BACB, so all of the items that are on the task list. But we also add in additional information that might not necessarily be on the task list that you wouldn't get in other places. So I think it's like the task list and beyond without the cost.
Can you give me some examples of the additional information that you've added?
Yeah, one is we went into an in-depth discussion of shaping. And I think, to me, that's a passion of mine. It's a lost art within our field because it requires a lot of in-the-moment assessment and analysis, and I think you don't get a lot of training on that. Luckily, it's in the second edition of the RBT task list, but I don't think everyone has really jumped on board with including that in their training, so that's just one.
I think the two that are big for me are that we have a good amount of information on curriculum and curriculum development so that we can teach children with autism the right skills and the right behaviors so that they can make meaningful outcomes. I think the other thing that we talk about, which is not on the task list, is clinical sensitivity. Understanding how to work with families and how to work with parents and what parents go through when they have a child diagnosed with autism and their journey so that they can be effective technicians or clinicians.